everyone. In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to create flood simulation and modeling in ArcGIS. Flood simulations is very good for assessing the impact of flood on public infrastructure. So today, I want to take you through how to create flood simulation in ArcGIS. And the data requirement is digital elevation model. So we want to use digital elevation model to model and simulate flood scenario in ArcGIS. So in ArcGIS, let's open our ArcGIS and bring in digital elevation model. So that's the first step, bring the digital elevation model. I want to use this then and click on add. So this is the digital elevation model I want to use. So if I go back here, these are the steps we will follow. The first one is to add this digital elevation model to ArcMap interface. Now we have done that, and there are a few things we need to check here. The minimum value height of this digital elevation model is minus 21, and the maximum value, the highest height, is 117 meter. It's in meter. The elevation is in meter. So another thing we can do a quick check. Just right click and go to properties of this digital elevation model to see the properties of this digital elevation model proper. So you can see the columns and rows, the number of band, the cell size is about 30 meter, and other informations. You can choose to check other information about the digital elevation model. Now, if you look at step two, is to create a base height. We want to create a base height for our digital elevation model. So to do that, click on Arc Toolbox, go to Spatial Analysis Tool, and go to Reclass. So we want to reclassify this digital elevation model. Double click this to open it, and we click here and load in our digital elevation model. Click on classify, and we are classifying into just a single class, one. So we are classifying into a single class. So what we want to do, we want to create a base height, and the minimum height here is minus 21. Take this into consideration. So what we will do is we create a base height. By so doing, we reclassify it into one. So click on OK, and the new value, this is the old value from minus 21 to plus 117. So the new value will be our minimum value, which is minus 21. So here we navigate to the folder where we want to save it. So I want us to save in our exercise folder and call it base height, for instance, base height, and click on save, then click on OK. So the process is running, background reclassifying it to create a base height, which we need to use in creating a flood simulation. In few seconds, it will be done. Yes, it has created a base height, and if you look at it, the value is minus 21. If you right click and go to the attribute table of this, you see that the value is minus 21. That is the lowest value of the digital elevation model. We have used it to create the base height. Now that I've done this, come to start and locate ArcGIS folder and open the Arc scene. This is Arc scene. Launch it. So I've already launched it. Let me bring it in. So this is interface of Arc scene. So what to do here, if you look at our step three, is to launch the Arc scene, which we have done, then add the digital elevation model into the ArcGIS. So let's load the digital elevation model. To do that, click on add, and this is our digital elevation model. Add it. So we have added it. But as if you look at it, it's just a plain height. It's a flat surface. So what to do now, we want to create it into, we want to make it 3D. So to do that, come to this Then right click and go to properties. Then come to base height here. Base height. So we want to create from here elevation from surface. We want to create the elevations from itself. So to do that, click on here, floating on custom surface. Then click on apply and click on OK. However, you cannot see the 3D because we have not adjusted the height exaggeration or vertical exaggeration. So to do that, what we do is you come to this scene layer, right click and go to scene properties, right click on scene properties under general. So here the vertical exaggeration, you can enter it manually or calculate from extent. So for the best result, let's calculate from extent. Click on calculate from extent, so it will give us the accurate value. Here we have 88.87. so click on apply and click on OK. So we can see the vertical exaggeration of our digital elevation model. Now at this point, you can change the color. Click here and change the color, invert it and click on OK. So we can see the vertical exaggeration of our digital elevation model. Now the next step, which is we have gotten the elevation and vertical exaggeration of the dam. The next thing now is to add the base height to axing. The base height we created initially, we want to add it now. So to do that, click here, add, look for base height. This is it, the base height we created the other time, and click on add. When you click on add, it has been added. However, we may not be able to see it clearly until we come back to this base height, go to properties, then come to base height, and here also repeat the same thing. Check this floating on a custom surface and click on apply. Click on OK. So what it means, we can now see the base of this surface. So which means if flood is to occur, the starting point for the flood will be here and it will rise up. So that is what it means. Now we want to see the, we want to start the flood simulation proper. So to do that, if you come back here, for example, and just want to verify the lowest and the highest points of this digital elevation model, you can just pick the identify tool. And if you click here, for instance, click on this point, for instance, it will show us the value at this point, and that is pixel value, that's minus 21 here. Then if you click at the highest level here, it will show us the value here, it is 58. So now what we want to do is the simulations. Pick the navigation tool. So we want to simulate flood, and you can come here, this base height, let's just change the color to, let's say, water body color, and click on OK. So we want to see how flood will rise from this base height and move up and occupy the spaces here. So to do that, we want to see it at different stages. So let's right click here and you see animation, or you can come to customize, come to tools, and you see animations. So you click on animations. So when you click on animation, come to this animation and click the drop down, you see animation manager. Click on animation manager. So under keyframes, these keyframes, click on create. Click on create. Then here you see type, the type is layer, and the source object is our base height. So then we want to create a flood at different heights. Let's say we want to create it at 8 different scenario or heights. So let's, you to do that, you click here new. So we click on new. I want to create for about 8 different heights. So in that case, I'll click on this create 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, then you click on close. So after we have done that, so you come to this translation Z, this translation. So let's say we want to simulate this flood when the flood is at 5 meter high, when it is at 10, then when it is 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40. So after we have done this, so after this, you can now close. So then you come back here to this animation. You see open animation control. Click on that. Then click on options. Click on options. So we want to simulate for, let's say, 15 seconds. So let's say you want to simulate for 15 seconds. You write 15 here. You can simulate for 10 seconds, 20 seconds. Let's just simulate in this exercise for 15 seconds. Then here, how do you want to play it, the simulations? So let's say you want to play loop forward and reverse. So loop forward and reverse. How do you want the flood to fill the space, and how do you want it to drain or discharge? So then after this, so after you have chosen the mode of fill and discharge of the flood, you click on play. When you click on play, see, it's playing out. So the flood will be coming. This is how it will occupy. This is how the flood simulation will be. You can see it here. You can zoom in. So this is discharge. It's discharging. It's discharging. Okay. Okay. So you can play it again. So how the flood comes up. This is how it comes up. You can see how it occupy, how it move and fill this place. This is the area, the highest level it will reach. Remember, the highest level was at 40 meter when we are selecting it. So this is how it is discharging. So this is how to simulate. And what the next thing we can do now is we can change the perspective of this to see how the flood fill the place and how it discharges. So we can actually use this to know the extent of infrastructure or facilities that will be affected in scenario of flood or when flooding occur. You can see it. So the next thing you can do now is that you can export these animations so that you can use it in presentations or in any other things you want to use it for. So to do that, just you can stop and close this, then come back to animation, see animation, and you see export animations. When you click on export animation, let's save it, for example, on our desktop. Let's save on our desktop and call it animation, for example, animations, and click on exports. So let's export it as animation, then click on OK. It will be exported. So the export is going on. In the next few seconds, it will be exported. Then you can now play it as an animations. You can use it in your PowerPoint presentations and other things to demonstrate flooding scenario in your study area. If we go back and to our desktop, okay, it has been exported. Right click and let's open with Gun Player and see how the animation looks like. Yes, this is it. So this is the animation. You can use it in your PowerPoint, in your presentations. So this is how the flood filled up the place. So in essence, this is how to simulate or model flood in ArcGIS using digital elevation model. Please subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching.